Let's post-process the stresses. If I go to a slide from the pre-analysis where I had the stress-strain relations, I see to calculate sigma x, I need the normal strains, and the normal strains I can get by differentiating the displacement interpolations. So ultimately, you know, sigma x is going to come from the nodal displacements. So let's get answers to do that, to calculate, you know, sigma x. So I'll go into mechanical. I can manipulate the view here. I can just say zoom to fit, make sure it's along Z. So if it's rotated, if I click on Z, I can look along Z. And then I will say stress. Note that, you know, I can also post-process the strains, which I won't do here. I'll just do the stresses, and I'll say normal. And this is the normal stress in the x direction, which we have denoted as sigma x. So I'll right-click, rename. I'll call this sigma underscore x, and that's a function of x and y. And then if I right click, I can say evaluate all results. And I can move this, I can hold down the control key, and using the middle mouse button, I can move it, or I can translate it using this option here. I can look at this without the elements if I want to. I can just say no wireframe. And I can also get smooth contours like that, which I won't, I'll go back to contour bands. So there are, you know, options here where you can manipulate the result. And it looks uniform away from the hole, which is what we expect. And so I'll probe the stress over here. And you see, as I move to the right boundary, it's around 20,000 PSI, which is what I expect. So that's good. That's a check on the boundary condition at the right edge. And then if I look at the maximum, so I can zoom in using the right mouse button, the maximum occurs over here, which is what we expect from the analytical solution. And you can see it's about three times, the applied, you know, traction at the right edge. So the stress concentration factor is around 3, which is what we're expecting. So that's also good. And I'll also show you how to extract the stress along, you know, a particular line. So let's say I want to extract the stress along that line here. In fact, let's do sigma theta rather than sigma, you know, x. So first, I need to draw that line, which I do under path. So I'll go to model, and I'll say construction geometry, and I will and then once construction geometry is highlighted, I will select path. I'll rename this as my path. Okay, so I'll get, you know, the default number of samples along that path. Let's start this over here. So that's going to be 0.25 inches. Okay, so it's starting over here, and then it ends over here. That would be 0.25. Okay, so the start and the end look right, but we need it in along the arc, which we can get by switching to the polar coordinates. So come into coordinate systems and say create coordinate system. This is a very powerful feature where you can create, you know, new coordinate systems and then get results in you know, that coordinate system. And I'll say the coordinate system type I want is cylindrical, which will give me a polar coordinate system. Defined by, I will say global coordinates, okay? And see, it shows that the radial coordinate is there, and that's theta. So you have to interpret this as r, and you have to interpret this as theta. And now, if I go back to my path and I say the path coordinate system is this new coordinate system. I can rename it as polar coordinate system, which I won't do here. So I have it in the new coordinate system and see I have the path. And then I want to get sigma theta along that path. So I'll highlight solution in the tree and I'll say stress normal. And let me rename that. So I'll say sigma underscore theta along hole. And I'll try to spell it right. And so I want this to be along the path rather than over the whole geometry. And I have to select my path, okay? And the stress is, let me leave this as X, but change the coordinate system to coordinate system, which is the polar coordinate system. So this is essentially sigma R. And if I say evaluate all results, okay, that gives me the value of sigma R along there. Now this should be zero, and it's different from zero. It's small compared to 20,000 PSI, but it's not zero because stresses are, you know, natural boundary conditions. And I talk about natural boundary conditions and the big ideas in finite element analysis. So these natural or gradient type of boundary conditions are satisfied only approximately. So it should see this getting smaller and smaller as you refine the mesh. But we don't want sigma R, we want sigma theta, so I'll switch this to Y, okay? And then I will say evaluate all results. Okay, now you see that I'm getting sigma theta, and over here sigma theta is same as sigma X, and I'm getting, you know, around 60,000 PSI, which is good. And I can look at this as a graph. So this is the distance along the hole. And that's basically the arc, the distance along the arc. Let me, I guess I lost the view over here. And, but I can also, you know, I can compare this to the analytical result, for the infinite plate. For that, what I'll do is I'll go to tabular data. So it gives me all those values along that hole for how many of our sampling points I have. And I can say control A to select all those values, control C to copy, and then I can go into Excel and do control V and paste it. And then, you know, and then I can use that to plot the comparison with the analytical solution. Okay, and so that's all I wanted to do over here. So I will save the project, and you might want to overwrite the WBPZ2.